Pat here. I've got video number two of our follow-up from the half hour to a healthy back workshop. And in this video, we're going over deep postural correction, okay? So this makes some really great changes. Anyone who feels a lot of tightness and tension through their back here after a long day at work, the foam roller will show you how to deal with that. And also we're gonna cover using the massage balls here. They get in a lot deeper and more specifically than the foam roller does, but both are really crucial keys. So what I ask people to do is, you know, depending what stage you're at in your pain levels and your spinal health, generally they'll do the full spinal range of motion every morning, and then they'll alternate the deep postural correction with the strengthening. Depending how you go for time, there's no harm doing it at all. If people are really quite mobile and moving well and fairly advanced in their care and how their spine is working, they might only do the deep postural correction maybe once or twice a week and do a bit more strengthening. So it's just a matter of everyone, working out where they're at, but I'd certainly suggest three times a week or every other day you need to be working on these in the short term. So postural correction, what we're trying to do is undo this yucky forward desk and sitting posture that a lot of people come in with these days. And I'm seeing younger and younger people coming in with their spine in a bad shape. So we really need to prioritize this. Now, what we do is we have a foam roller. I like these ones. They're a bit firmer with the hollow part in the middle, but you know, whichever one you've got a hand will do the job nicely. So we want to start with that at the level of our ribs. This is our start position, feet flat on the ground, foam roller at my lower ribs. I'm going to put my hands at the back of my hip to stabilize it and bring my elbows together. That's really important to get the shoulder blades out of the way. Okay, so here's our start position. Bottom comes up, so I'm parallel to the ground. All my weight is on the roller at the moment. I'm going to spend a minute going up and down the roller, seeing where my tight spots are, getting some blood moving to the area and generally warming up my back. So here we go. To my neck, to my ribs. And I'm finding out pretty early on that this is my real tight area down here. So some people like to do this just to massage their back. I'm going to park up at those lower ribs again. Now I need to get some movement back over my out of my chest here. So stabilize again and open up. We're going to spend a couple of minutes working on this. So rather than just get people into a deep bend and hold, I like to work through the zone and just see what the limits are, hold it for a few seconds, find the next spot, and just spend a bit of time opening your chest up. Now the roller's positioned just in the lower part of my shoulder blades and down. Once you get up here, there's nowhere really to bend back too much, okay? The balls are better used up there. So we're really working on opening that chest up. But when you get good at this, you just really find your spot, arc back, and hold there for 20, 30, 40 seconds. Also, you can get some rotation in the spine by putting all your weight back against the roller and rotating the arms. Okay? So that's how we use the roller. Some people find it uncomfortable. It depends on the roller, but it does get easier over time. Be careful to keep those shoulder blades apart. These are the yoga tune-up balls that I suggest. They've got a really nice density and texture. The muscles of the spine allow those to get in nice and deep. So you need to level them off at the shoulder blades, drop your weight back, elbows together again, chin forward, find the upper part of your back, the vertebrae in there, and drop all your weight over it. Once we're here, this is our start position, arms go up to the sky, and we bring our hands down over our head, down towards the ground. If that's a tight area, you might do it 15 or 20 times. Then we point at the ceiling, and we rotate. Rotating these stiff joints of the upper back. And you work along. So as I said earlier, my tightness is quite low down, so I'll spend a bit of time getting some rotation through this part of my back and opening it up, okay? Really great, easy way to promote deep opening of the spinal joints, and you'll find really nice relief of tight muscles if you use these on that part of your back. It's one of those things, if I was on a desert island, I would need a set of these balls to look after my back. I use them up in my, to look after my shoulders, my hips and things like that as well. So both of those are very useful. You get a broader, bigger opening with the foam roller, a more precise, specific work done with the massage ball. So have fun with those 2 to 3 times a week.